entertainment blog on the internet today, the A-List. I am your host, the man who is running up against Kim Kardashian to be mayor. I've had more sex in porta potties than Gerard Butler, and I've saved more teenage girls than Mitt Romney. I am the game changer, Wes Troop. And we're here to talk about what went down in the entertainment world this week. But first off, I'd like to thank all my new subscribers, all my new Twitter followers. Raven Taven, what's up, girl? Ricky Tikki Tavi, whatever. All right. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's get on with the show. Uh-oh, you hear the piano? He hasn't been here in a while. Ladies and gentlemen, Neil Sedaka. Yeah, all right, so this is my segment where we see who broke up in the celebrity world. Splitsville. All right, so what do we got this week, peeps? Elisabetta Canalis and Steve-O have split. Really, writers? That's the best you got for me. Anyway, I thought that relationship would have lasted, really? She goes from George Clooney to Steve-O? Anyway, now let's hope this segment's a little better. Writers, someone's getting fired. Oh, that's right, I write this shit. God. Anyway, I shall fire myself. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, let's do my segment now. Let me put my baby into you. Surprisingly, that's not the first time I've ever said that sentence. All right. Anyway, we have expecting Hollywood celebrities. For those of you who like the True Blood out there, not really a fan. I've never really watched it, though, but I've seen certain scenes, if you will. I think you people out there know what I'm talking about. But anyway, True Blood actors Anna Paquin and Stephen Moyer are expecting a baby. Oh, joy. So anyway, I wonder if he's going to have to, like, suck the venom out. Oh, that's right. That's that other stupid vampire shit. Now it's time for me to get some of my respect back for my peeps. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for your favorite segment and mine. Fanboys are... us! And you know what that means? I gotta pick a musical instrument to play. I'm thinking ukulele! Just like Tiny Tim, baby! Just like Tiny Tim! I've been called that before, too. Don't make pay any attention to that Benjamin Franklin! Oh! Whoa, boy! Whoa! Alright. This could be the worst episode I've ever done. It might be. Those of you who are going to see the Avengers, which is a lot of people, because evidently this is the most anticipated movie of the summer, because, well, get ready. First of all, you're in for a hell of a ride with the movie, and second of all, now there's going to be a new Dark Knight Rises trailer attached to the Avengers film. Even more awesome! It's not even out yet, but we're talking about the sequel already! Avengers 2 news, Quicksilver, and the Scarlet Witch could be part of the second film. Avengers 2, ladies and gentlemen. And for the fanboys out there, you know who they are. For those who don't, Magneto's son and daughter. Interesting. Throwing in the X-Men in there, kinda, sorta. They're Avengers, but you know what I mean. You get it. You get the drift, peeps. Anyway, on to other movie news. Disney has announced they are planning on making a film off of another one of their amusement park rides. Oh boy, I'm excited to hear this one. Except, it's Mr. Toad's Wild Ride. Alright, I don't think that's a very good idea. That ride, I was on it once, and it made, like, no sense. But, whatever, it made no sense for as a kid, it makes no sense as an adult. They demolished that ride in Disney World, now it's just in Disneyland. I don't know. I think Wes Troop's Wild Ride would be much better. Oh yeah, baby. Just ask some of my lady friends how that ride goes. Whoa! Alright, so, peeps, is it getting any better? I don't think so. Anyway, Now it's time for me to tell you what happened down in the reality world this week of reality television. This is my reality report! Sweet. Okay, so, ladies and gentlemen, this week on American Idol, I sort of like this guy, but I don't know. He sort of seems one-dimensional. Colton Dixon was eliminated from American Idol. The guy never been in the bottom three, and he's out. I have other favorites in the competition, so. Anyway, Colton Dixon, sayonara, sucka. Also, on Dancing with the Stars, for anyone who still watches this show, I don't really anymore because there's, no one I care about in the show. Gavin DeGraw got voted off. Oh. And he can ride his chariot right out of here. Get it? Chariot, Gavin DeGraw. Well, have this get on my shoulder. Well, you know what that means. It's time for me to make my weekly box office prediction. It's time for the B.O. Yeah, baby. B.O.P. up in this bitch. All right, anyway. All right, so last week I said that The Hunger Games would get knocked off of its little pedestal and that, what did I say? Cabin in the Woods would be number one. By the way, look out for my Cabin in the Woods review tomorrow, which is Monday. All right, so, Cabin in the Woods was not number one. I was wrong. Yes, I know. Hunger Games kept it, making me 121-39. Still not a too shabby record there, if I can say so myself. So this week, I am demanding The Hunger Games goes down. They're going hungry, baby. This week, I say the comedy Think Like a Man, which evidently sounds a lot like the album I released back when I was 15, called How to Be a Man. A lot of people got a lot of useful tips off of that, too, by the way. I think Like a Man will be the number one film. Hopefully. And that brings us to this week's Babe of the Week. And this week, I think I'm going to give it to a little lady I like on television this week. The show Fact or Faked Paranormal Files came back on. So, I'm looking and I'm liking at this little number. Ladies and gentlemen, this week's Babe of the Week is J.L. DePardo. No, I did not just give it to Gerard DePardieu. Alright, anyway. So, that's all the time we've got for this week, peeps. But until next time, don't miss one single playlist. You can subscribe to me right here on YouTube. Let's go get this done. You can like me on Facebook, follow me on the Twitter, and of course, check out this week and every review at And don't forget to spend your hard-earned money on me. We haven't seen this one for a while. Snug it out of the closet. This is